all too well.
And you know I like a good...
Can I help you?
I believe you can. I'm Sophronia, by the way. And I need help from someone who's at least a fifth year. Are you familiar with Herodiana Byrne? Don't answer that. Of course you're not. No one seems to know of her but me. She's only the single greatest Depulso master of all time. Even taught at Hogwarts, briefly.
How interesting. I'm amazed I've never heard of her.
It's a travesty she's not more well known. I often read about great witches in my limited free time. There are many. Whilst reading about her, I learned that she built a secret Depulso training room here at Hogwarts. But in typical clever Herodiana fashion, one cannot access it unless one knows Depulso, which, of course, third years aren't taught.
And you're a third year, so...
Quick one, aren't you? According to what I've read, her signature outfit may still be there. I would love to see it. Would you get Herodiana's signature outfit and show it to me?
How did Herodiana Byrne become famous by casting Depulso?
She once saved orphans from a wild Graphorn by banishing it over Stonehenge. That's on Salisbury Plain. She once banished a meddlesome dark wizard all the way to Durmstrang while she was in the Alps. That one may have been exaggerated, but lots of the stories about her certainly aren't.
What ended up happening to Herodiana Byrne?
In her later years, she taught at Hogwarts, but only for a short while. Just long enough to build a secret hall, it appears. Then one day, she just disappeared. Some say she actually banished herself. No one knows for sure.
If you tell me where to go, I'll see what I can do about it.
Simply go to the Hall of Herodiana. It's at the base of the Defense Against the Dark Arts Tower. There, you'll find a series of Depulso puzzles concealing pieces of Herodiana's ensemble.
Very well. I shall let you know if I find anything.
I can't wait to see Herodiana's famous ensemble. Perhaps I'll make myself a copy.
Suppose I should look for that secret hall Sophronia told me about. It does sound interesting. This must be the entrance to the Hall of Herodiana. Well, here it is. The Hall of Herodiana. Better go inside and find those puzzles. To see if Herodiana Byrne is as good as Sophronia said she was.
Revelio!
switch reset everything. Good to know. That's the last of them. Seems I was a match for Herodiana Byrne after all. And this must be the last piece of Herodiana's ensemble. It is remarkable. No wonder Sophronia wants to see this. Sophronia! I solved all the puzzles in the Hall of Herodiana.
Incredible! Then you found Herodiana's outfit. May I see it?
Of course. Behold.
Oh, how grand! You look as majestic as Herodiana herself, the greatest Depulso master of all time. You're my second favorite hero!
You'll see it was a mistake parting ways with me.
Sir, is everything all right?
How kind of you to ask. The name's Ackley Barnes. And no, it is not. I'm plotting a sort of revenge against my ex-business partner, a conniving fiend by the name of Alfred Lawley. He cut me out of our herbology supply business just as we were getting started. Said I was too volatile to work with. I'll show him volatile.
That must have been frustrating for you.
Yes, yes it was. Terribly. I'm simply passionate about my work. Supercilious fool. He's passionate about things too, as I intend to remind him by relieving him of his prized possession. A venomous tentacular he's grown from a seedling that was to be the keystone of our business venture. I can't get anywhere near it with Ruth Singer watching me like an augury. Lawley's doing, no doubt. But no one would suspect a student. How would you feel about committing some grand plant larceny?
You said Mr. Lawley was your ex-business partner. What were you working on?
I had an idea to train venomous tentacular, create guard plants, if you will, that attacked when ordered. We hit a snag when one ate Lawley's neasel. After that, he cut me out of the business, the short-sighted fiend.
Why do you need Mr. Lawley's venomous tentacular in particular?
Simple. If I have it, then Lawley doesn't. Ergo, I can launch my business, and he must start all over again. I'm killing two snidgets with one stone.
What else is in Mr. Lawley's cellar?
All of Lawley's herbology supplies. He has quite the collection. Fill your pockets while you're there. Or to slow him down for a bit. And I can get my business going, minus any competition.
I'll get the venomous tentacular for you.
Marvellous. I know a fellow seeker of justice when I see one. Take as many herbology supplies as you like while you're in his cellar. All I ask is that you bring me the venomous tentacular. Remember, I just need that venomous tentacular.
Seems I need to find... This must be it. This must be the cellar. How to... It's tentacular. Better not let Mr. Lawley see me. The venomous tentacular, I should return to Mr. Barnes.
Confringo!
Revelio! Revelio.
Any luck retrieving a certain friend of mine from a former friend?
Hello, Mr. Barnes. I have that venomous tentacular.
Ha! Wish I could see Lawley's face when he realizes his prized possession is gone. We'll see who's volatile now. Well done. I'll take it off your hands now.
Of course. Glad to hand it over, frankly.
I shall make an ocean of galleons, and Lawley's business will be sunk. Here's a little something for your next trip to Zonko's. Oh, to see the look on Lawley's face the next time he wanders down to his cellar.
Glad you came.
Hello, Serona. I received your owl. How are you?
Hello, my friend. Did you ever find Lord Gog?
I did, thank you. We had a good conversation. He sends you his best.
Glad to hear it. I shan't ask for details of your little chat, and I'll refrain from telling you to be careful yet again. But I hope you will be, whatever your plans.
Of course. Your owl mentioned you're needing my help with something?
I do. I thought you might be just the person to do a favour for my friend Dorothy Sprottle in Upper Hogsfield.
I don't believe I've met Mrs. Sprottle.
She's lovely. Her late husband Aidan was a friend of my father's. In fact, I'd stay with Dot and Aidan the summers I waited tables here as a student. I've seen her a few times since Aidan passed, but the pub's been so busy lately, I've not been as attentive as I'd have liked. I wonder if you might pop in and see her. She may need some help collecting ingredients for her supply of Wiganweld potion, and you could retrieve something of mine in the process. A box, full of old letters and such.
Why does Mrs. Sprottle keep a supply of Wiganweld potion on hand?
Dot's a skilled potioner. She's been supplying travelling vendors with Wiganweld potion. An ordinary precaution that has, unfortunately, become a necessity, what with Ranrock's loyalists disrupting the trade routes.
Why did Mr. and Mrs. Sprottle have your box of letters after all this time?
It's one of a few that I had when I was young. Dot found it when she was clearing out a closet. Can't imagine what's in there. Probably terribly theatrical. Ramblings of a teenage witch and her friends. You're welcome to take a peek inside, if you do find it. To be honest, I'd imagine it contains some lovely memories.
I'll try to go and see her when I can.
It would mean the world to me, and to Dorothy. Aidan was bringing the box of letters to me when he was taken ill. Doc can tell you where he might have dropped it. You'll find the hamlet just north of Hogsmeade. Please do give Doc my love.
Ah, Upper Hogsfield. Now where to find Mrs. Sprottle? Seems a pleasant enough little...
Shane Bardolph thought dark magic was the answer. I reckon Rookwood's played a hand in his disappearance.
Hello, Mrs. Sprottle. Actually, Serona Ryan asked if I'd come and see you.
Dear Serona, a gem, has been for as long as I've known her.
She thought you might need help collecting ingredients for your Wiganweld potion.
And she's correct. My darling Aidan used to collect hawk lumps for me. Since he died, my supply has dwindled.
I'm sorry for your loss, Mrs. Brottle.
Oh, thank you. Love of my life. A bit lost without him. If you wouldn't mind gathering some hawk lumps for me, I'd be happy to compensate you for your time.
Believe it or not, I have some with me.
Oh, thank you. How wonderful. The travelling vendors will be thrilled to replenish their stock of Wiganweld potion.
Serona also mentioned that Mr. Sprottle was bringing her a box of letters when he fell ill.
Indeed he was. I'd almost forgotten. I stumbled upon it just before Aidan died. He was hoping to go through it with Serona over a butterbeer or two. Those two were always like two bow truckles in a branch. Aidan took ill when he was collecting hawk clumps on his way to see her. He made it home, but I fear he dropped the box in the cavern. The cavern is in the hills just southwest of our hamlet. You can gather hawk clumps and collect the box of letters there.
Serona said she lived with you during the summers when she was at Hogwarts. What was she like?
Oh, goodness. Well, she was almost exactly like she is now. Charming, good head on her shoulders, taking care of everyone. I can't tell you the fun we had when she and her friends would visit us during the year, all buzzing about, practicing charms. Talented group. Her friend Mirabel was a genius in the garden. Learned it all from her muggle parents, if you can believe it.
Do you remember anything about the letters you put in the box?
Oh, of course. A few letters from some of her school friends. Some nice memories. I even included a letter Serona had written to me when she was staying with us. Thought she might enjoy reading it. I know when I read writing from my youth, I'm always astonished at how much I've changed, and yet remain the same.
Thank you, Mrs. Brottle.
Thank you. I'll be here if you are able to collect those hawk clumps. I, and the vendors I help, would greatly appreciate it.
This must be the cavern Mrs. Brottle mentioned. Gave the hawk clumps to Mrs. Brottle, but I still need to visit the cave to better have a look around. See about the hawk clumps and the box of letters.
Kunfringer! Revelio!
That's all the hawk clumps for now. Mrs. Brottle should be pleased.
Revelio.
In London.
Revelio. Lumos. Revelio. Lumos. Lumos. Revelio. Revelio. Confirm. Revelio. This must be Sorona's box of letters. I should take this box. I think that's everything. Sorona will be glad to have this back. Hello, Sorona. I have good news. I was able to provide your friend Mrs. Sprottle with some hawk clumps for her Wiggermel potion, and I found your box of letters.
Oh, thank you. I knew you were the one to ask.
I wondered about some of the letters in the box.
Of course. It appears most of the letters were from fellow students.
One of the letters mentions Quidditch practice. Did you play?
I did. Was the Ravenclaw Seeker for 3 years. Oh, Merlin's beard. I adore Quidditch. Nothing like the feeling of catching the golden snitch when your team's down by 140 points. I'll never forgive Professor Black for cancelling it this year. I missed cheering for Ravenclaw.
I saw a letter from someone named Mirabelle. Is that Professor Garlick?
It is. Still one of my dearest friends. I know she wouldn't mind you having seen that letter. She and I are of a similar mind, especially when it comes to young people. We believe experience to be an invaluable teacher. To borrow a phrase from Mirabelle, it's a joy to see anyone blossom, but particularly one who doubted they ever would.
I spotted a letter from you to Mrs. Sprottle. You two seem to have a lot of fun together.
We do. She taught me so much during my summers with her and Aiden. I shall be the first to admit that adolescents aren't always the easiest to understand. And not everyone was as kind to me as the Sprottles. But the depth of their kindness, and that of so many of my friends, got me through some challenging times, to put it mildly.
I'm glad I could be of help. Mrs. Sprottle sends her best.
Don't know what I'd have done without her and Aiden. Thank you, again, for helping her. And for returning this box of letters. It's nice to reflect on good memories.